Eli and I went to the children's home to adopt a little girl. But the moment we met, a boy came into the room saying, "Mommy, Daddy, hi. I've been waiting for you for so long." I burst into tears. The boy was Lizzie's brother. They were twins. "We can't take two kids," my hubby yelled. "I can't support them financially." But I begged him to take the boy too. How could I separate a brother and sister? There was enough room in the house for everyone. But soon, there wasn't enough room for anyone. At night, a fire started, and the house burned down. I barely had time to get Lizzie and Ronnie out. Meanwhile, Eli was saving his valuables and baseball collection. We stayed at my friend's house for a while, but Eli left us, along with the insurance payout for the house. Before he left, he said the kids had set the house on fire and reminded me he'd asked me not to adopt anyone, as if he was still hoping I'd get pregnant after being married 10 years. But now I realized he just didn't love me anymore. A day later, social workers came and took my kids away. "Mommy, don't give us up," cried Ronnie and Lizzie. But I couldn't do a thing. "I promise I'll come back and get you. Just remember my song and you'll be comforted, as if you were home." I used to write songs, so I wrote a lullaby for my kids. After that, I settled in at work, in a back room that my boss let me rent. But every night, I saw the eyes of my son and daughter in front of me. I went to the children's home and got a job as a cleaner. They wanted to turn me down, but they saw how I managed to calm a few naughty kids with one song. They hired me as a nanny. I could see my Ronnie and Lizzie again. At night, I kept singing lullabies to them. In the daytime, I played with them and fed them. But my joy didn't last long. They found a new family for Lizzie. My world fell apart overnight. Ronnie and Lizzie would be separated forever, and I'd never see Lizzie again. I knew Ronnie was bound to be adopted soon. I'd be alone. Lizzie didn't want to go away. She cried and fought back. But I knew it was probably for the best for her. After all, what could I give Lizzie and Ronnie? I had nothing but my lullabies and songs. That night, I sang a few of my lullabies, told my story, and posted it all on social media. Within a day, my phone went crazy with messages. Reporters were asking me for interviews. Users wrote I should release an album. And soon a producer contacted me. We recorded an album and it was successful. I started the re-adoption process for Ronnie. But then Eli showed up. He'd gone to social services and told them I was a bad mom and they shouldn't give me the kids. Eli envied my success. They didn't let me adopt Ronnie. So I went to the police station and asked to have our house inspected again. I wondered where the fire had started, and my suspicions were confirmed. The fire started in the garage. Eli was the only one who went in there. I did something incredible. I went on TV and told my story again. I told about my adoption struggles and the fire that was Eli's fault. I also sang a lullaby that I'd written for Ronnie and Lizzie. That way, the whole country could see us, even Lizzie's new parents and social services. After seeing this show, social services allowed me to adopt Ronnie. And soon, a man and woman knocked on my door. Lizzie was with them. I opened the door, and Lizzie rushed into my arms. I didn't see or feel anything at that moment, except my own salty tears. The man and woman who wanted to adopt Lizzie told me she was always crying and moody. And as soon as she saw me on TV, she freaked out. We realized who she thought her mom was, the man said. So we decided not to torture the child. I got the family I dreamed of, and Eli got punished for lying. He was arrested for burning down the house to get insurance and to get rid of me and the kids. Now he finally got rid of everyone who once loved him for so long.
Thank you.